Oh, your hair's great.
Oh, great. Hi!
And she's cooling down nicely, too.
Yeah. Well, they wasn't too happy about the hill.
It's probably the most young people you've had in a long time, aren't you?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. This
is easy.
You want me to hold your tray? Throw it on the ground.
Oh, this is great.
There you go.
Yeah, get up.
All right, guys.
How does the wheel feel?
Blue, baby.
How's the wheel turn?
A big car. We've got room for everybody.
A lot of fun with these electrics. It seems funny at every show you go to, most people aren't aware that there were more electrics before 1918 than there were gas cars. And it's everyone thinks that gas cars, that electric cars today are new or are a new thing. So we really enjoy having the car out and talking with people and explaining about the early electrics.
They had a tiller instead of a steering wheel.
No,
yeah, yeah, but you like a boat, yeah.
Be cool.
There you go, put a whole row in. You at least three of you on this seat.
Oh, this is really cool.
See, at least three of them. Here, see?
Oh my gosh, this is
so fun. Okay, Jack,
now there's room for one on each running board.
No, we're okay.
And now Jack's going to climb in and sit on your lap. That's a good horn.
Go surfing now, everybody's learning how. Come on a safari with me.
I'm so
Gillette. We have a 66 Mustang Fastback, a rare color, silver. It's a 289 V8, four-speed transmission, and I've had every nut and bolt apart except for the transmission. A lot of fun. We bought it in 1987, and we've put over 122,000 miles on it. East Coast, Florida. We had a 65 coupe that was just an old car for the kids to drive back and forth to college. About the only thing is it sure is a beautiful place.
This is Hal Ratzlaff. I'm driving this 81 Corvette. It's been slightly modified. 350 engine with the high compression heads, all that four-speed transmission. And it's an everyday driver, pretty much. And special equipment put on this vehicle. Nothing else special about it. Interior is red, the exterior white. You don't find too many of them with that color.
Thanks.
New leather interior. I've had it now 3 years. Had to put a different hood on it because of the carburetor and air cleaner. It's not the standard stock. Like they used to have the injection engine. This is just a straight 350 modified.
Hello, my name is Jim Brady, and my wife Shirley. We have this 1950 Plymouth. A two-door coupe, special deluxe. It has a straight six flathead and produces 97 horsepower. Nothing like the Hemis that people think now of Chrysler cars. It's Salvador blue, and the accessories are fog lights, sun visor, and also the fender skirts are on the car. And I bought this car from a good friend of mine. He had passed away. And Byron Weed, and I bought it from his widow in September of 08. And he found it in Maryland. And then had it completely overhauled and repainted. Undercarriage has been repainted. And it's still just a good, reliable car that we enjoy taking to car shows.
Hi, my name is Ron Branham. My wife Dee and I own this 65 T-Bird. We've had it roughly 8-9 years now. It's been completely restored, and I found this in a barn out in Chelsea, and I knew the family from years ago, and I was just out there one day looking around, and I found the T-Bird. So Dee's always wanted one, and I kind of wanted one, so we wound up buying it, and we went through it, redid the motor, redid the transmission, did some body work on it, and this is what we have today.
I'm Walt Blanchard. This is my 39 Ford Deluxe. I've had it since 1990. It's got the V8 flathead, 85 horse, and kept it all original. It's pretty good shape.
Well now, Lord, Mr. Ford, I just wish that you could see what your simple horseless carriage has become. Well, it seems your contribution to man, to say the least, got a little out of hand. Well,
1955 Super Panama Clipper, two-door hardtop. It's got a 327 Packard V8 engine, power brakes. They made about 7,000 of these, and it's a real fun car. It's got a Continental kit on the back, and it's got the sore thumb tail lights in it. Very dependable car.
I have here a 1956 Studebaker Skyhawk. It was one of four Hawk models that Studebaker brought out in 1956. The top of the line was the Golden Hawk, which had a Packard engine in it. They were part of Studebaker Packard at that time. Then there was a flight of Skyhawk, like I have here, which has the Studebaker engine. Then there was the Power Hawk, which had a smaller Studebaker engine. And then the Flight Hawk that had the six-cylinder. I've always preferred the Skyhawk because it didn't have the goofy tacked on fins like the Golden Hawk, and it just aesthetically more pleasing, and it had the bigger of the engines in it. I restored it in 2005, 2006. Body work, mechanical restoration. I didn't have to touch the engine. However, I did have to put a four-speed, or I didn't have to. I chose to put a four-speed transmission in it, which I thought was a little more suited for a sporty type vehicle. That was all Studebaker equipment I put in it too, so it's a If you go to a Studebaker parts book, you can find just about everything that you need, should it ever have to be worked on.
Interesting.
I've had a lot of fun with it.
Okay, you girls having fun?
Yeah!
Let's go surfing now. Everybody's learning how. Come on a safari with me. Come on a safari with me. Yeah, me.
Steve, I appreciate you're taking the videos for the Motor City Golf Classic, and I'm standing here before Steve Rohde's 1926 Ford pickup truck. I want to say thank you to all of the participants, i.e. Chelsea Cruisers and others who came to show their cars. Without your cars, it would be just a golf event, and we're trying to make it more than that by calling it the Motor City Golf Classic. So again, thanks folks for bringing your cars. The weather held out for us, and I certainly do appreciate it. And Steve, a special thanks to you for the efforts that you did for us with the videoing. Thanks again.